Good morning, everybody. You're all looking nice, and what a beautiful morning over Scarborough. It's my joy to welcome everybody. In particular, we want to welcome members of the Diocesan Lewis Pilgrimage who are with us today. They've travelled down from Middlesbrough. I want to welcome also those who are joining. This week, all things being equal, the diocese would be on pilgrimage down in Lourdes, but because of limitations, we're having a virtual pilgrimage, and our representative group this morning, they're travelling round to the various churches in various parts of the diocese. So it's Scarborough who are hosting the Mass this morning. So to you, Middlesbrough, representing the diocese, welcome to you and thank you for making the journey. You have come to Scarborough, the best town in North Yorkshire. Scarborough, the best town in North Yorkshire after Middlesbrough, so welcome. I'd like to do and celebrate a Mass in honour of Our Lady today, in honour of Mary. So we begin by signing ourselves with the cross of Christ. The Lord be with you. You'll see there in front of the sanctuary the statue of Mary, Our Lady of Lourdes statue. And one of the things I like about this statue is I like the poise of Mary. Her hands are joined, but I also like that her eyes are towards heaven. And I don't know what that's saying to you, but it's a reminder to me that sometimes, just sometimes in life, we get so caught up in the things of time that we forget the things of heaven, the things of eternity. So Mary is reminding us to keep our gaze on higher things. So as we join our hearts and our voices and our hands in prayer, we think of all across the diocese who are linking up this morning and beyond our diocese. We think of our sick and those who are struggling with the pain of life. We ask Mary's intercession, Mary's protection, Mary's maternal care. Lord Jesus, you are Son of God, you are Son of Mary. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you are Word made flesh, you are the splendor of the Father. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you are mighty God and Prince of Peace. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. The newsletter intention is for Walter O'Leary. Everybody in Lourdes knows Doris O'Leary. She is the most famous person in Lourdes after St. Bernadette and Our Lady. So Doris some weeks ago sent me a Mass if I'd ask for the Mass for her husband's anniversary. And providentially, O'Leary. And Doris, if you are tuned in, we'll be thinking of you as well in our Mass. O God, who willed that your word should take on the reality of human flesh in the womb of the Virgin Mary, grant, we pray, that we who confess our Redeemer to be God and man may merit to become partakers even in his divine nature, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Be seated now as Keith Tillotson will proclaim our readings.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah. Rejoice, Jerusalem. Be glad for her, all you who love her. Rejoice, rejoice for her, all you who mourn her, that you may be suckled, filled from her consoling breast, that you may savour with delight her glorious breasts. For thus says the Lord, now towards her I send flowing peace like a river, and like a stream in spate the glory of the nations. At her breast will her nurslings be carried and fondled in her lap. Like a son comforted by his mother, will I comfort you, and by Jerusalem you will be comforted. At the sight of your heart will rejoice, and your bones flourish like the grass. To his servants the Lord will reveal his hand. This is the word of the Lord. Responsorial Psalm. The response is, you are the highest honour of our race.
You are the highest honour of our race.
May you be blessed, my daughter, by God Most High, beyond all women on earth. And may the Lord God be blessed, the Creator of heaven and earth.
You are
the highest honour of our race. The trust you have shown shall not pass from the memories of men, but shall ever remind them of the power of God. You are the highest honour of our race. Please stand to receive the gospel. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Blessed are you, Virgin Mary, who believed that the promise made you by the Lord would be fulfilled. Hallelujah.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Mary, she set out, and she went as quickly as she could to a town in the hill country of Judah. She went into Zechariah's house, and she greeted her cousin Elizabeth. Now, as soon as Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, the child leapt in her womb, and Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit. She gave a loud cry and said, "Of all women you are the most blessed, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. Why should I be honored with a visit from the mother of my Lord? For the moment your greeting reached my ears, the child in my womb leapt for joy. Yes, blessed is she who believed that the promise made her by the Lord would be fulfilled." And Mary said, "My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord, and my spirit exults in God my Saviour, because he day forward, all generations will call me blessed. For the Almighty has done great things for me. Holy is his name." The Gospel of the Lord. By the words of the Gospel, may our sins be blotted out. Amen. Seated now briefly. So again, we send greetings to all watching in on the live stream, all the housebound and those who are in care homes maybe, those watching in their own family home this morning. It's our great joy here to host the Mass this morning here from St. Peter's in Scarborough. When my mother died in 2012, one of my last memories of my mother, the night before she died, she was in a deep coma. Just to fill out the story a bit, she had fallen at home and she'd broken her hip. Like so many, she then developed complications, pneumonia, and then she was in a coma for maybe the most of a week. But one of the memories I have in the hospital that night, just before we made our long journey home, the nearest hospital to us at home is about 26 miles away. Just touching her cheek with my cheek, and it was the most tender moment. Cheek to cheek is a way to describe it. And I was reminded of that very, what I call, tender moment as Keith there was reading the first reading this morning. Like a son comforted by his mother, like a son comforted by his mother, will I comfort you. For those who travel to Lourdes with the pilgrimage, or even as private pilgrims, that is one of the great, I suppose one of the great comforts that Lourdes brings. It's like a son being comforted, like a daughter being comforted by their mother. In our gospel then that we've just listened to, what I like about the gospel is Mary, she's on the move. Mary is setting out the hill country of Judah. Now her cousin Elizabeth needed a bit of support and needed a bit of encouragement, because like Mary, she too had become pregnant. And Mary, forgetting about her own needs, so to speak, in those early days of pregnancy, she sets out as quickly as she could to a town in the hill country. So she had a bit of climbing to do. And she, after the long journey, she arrives at her cousin's house. And there she brings comfort and consolation and encouragement to her cousin. And they have this beautiful conversation. We have Elizabeth there saying to Mary, of all women you are the most blessed. What a beautiful salutation. Of all women you are the most blessed. And blessed is the fruit of your womb. And of course we use those words in the Hail Mary. I remember one time in Lourdes hearing a bishop speak about, it was a most beautiful and touching reflection. He was saying, and I still can remember his words, that not alone did Mary visit her cousin Elizabeth, but down the centuries and down the decades, Mary continues to make visitations to various individuals, to various places, to various countries, to various continents. And I was saying with our, to our folk here on Sunday, that I'm reading a book at the moment about apparitions of Our Lady and visions of Our Lady. And since the earliest days, there have been 20,000 visitations of Our Lady to various people, to various continents, to various countries. And one of those places that Mary went on visitation was not over the hills of Judea, but over the hills of the Pyrenees, when she appeared to a young maiden, a 14-year-old girl, Bernadette Soubirous. And when she appeared to Bernadette for those 18 apparitions, she too brought Bernadette a message of comfort. a message of consolation. As we pause now on this beautiful morning here over Scarborough, we just call on Mary to bring us comfort, to bring us consolation, to bring consolation and comfort to all out there who are poorly in any way, who are weighed down by the strain and distress of life, who are weighed down by illness or the frailty of old age. And maybe too in our own lives at this time, we too will need a bit of consolation and a bit of encouragement from Mary, our spiritual mother. Like a child comforted by his mother, will I comfort you. Of all women, you are the most blessed, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. So as we move now to the offertory, I'd just like to remember a young girl that I knew in Teesside called Tilly. And Tilly has had a serious operation over the last day or so. She is secondary school age. She's an identical twin. So we remember Tilly, who is recovering after some brain surgery. And to all her family at this time, we keep you two in our prayers. Now we're going to play a second hymn, I think, as we prepare the liturgy of the Eucharist. Pray, sisters, pray, brothers, that our sacrifice is acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Prayer over the offerings. Be pleased, Almighty and merciful God, be pleased to accept your church's offerings, so that she who is aware that her beginnings lie in the incarnation of your only begotten Son may rejoice to celebrate his mysteries on this special day, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your heart. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord, as we honour the Blessed Virgin Mary, Our Lady of Lourdes. For truly, even to the ends of the earth, you have done great things, and extended your abundant mercy from age to age. When you looked on the lowliness of your handmaid Mary, you gave us through her the author of our salvation, your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Through him the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoice in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Invite you to be seated, please. Invite you to be seated. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Holy Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more giving thanks, he gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring your church to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Terence, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Especially we remember all Lourdes pilgrims who have died. Welcome them and welcome Walter O'Leary into the light of your face. Have mercy upon us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, St. Bernadette Subaru, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen. Invite you now to stand, please. before the shrine there of Mary, before the statue of Mary, is the Lord's candle. And just before Mass there, we lit the candle, which this candle is traveling round again to various parts of our diocese. And again, as we gaze upon the candle there and gaze upon Mary, we pray in the words that her Son gave us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Prayer of protection. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always. Be free from sin, be safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Prayer for peace and unity, Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant your church peace and unity, in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord, the risen Lord, be with you always. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis.
Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, dona nobis.
As we continue to join with our live stream pilgrims, we make our act of faith in the Eucharistic Lord. Behold Jesus, the Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body and the blood of Christ bring us and all whom we are praying for to everlasting life. Amen. Just one or two practical, I hope practical, instructions. We come row by row now for Holy Communion, now for the blessing, and then we go back to our benches by going back down the side aisles. So do respect social distance as you come forward.
Thank you.
Let us stand. Let us pray. Grant us, O merciful God, grant us protection in our weakness, that we who honour the Immaculate Mother of God, Our Lady of Lourdes, may, with the help of her intercession, rise up from our iniquities, through Christ our Lord. Amen. We're going to offer some hospitality now to our pilgrims from not over the hill country of Judea, but over the hills of the North Yorkshire Moors. So just across the car park there is the Paris Centre. We're going to give you strawberries and cream. We're going to give you pavlova. We're going to give you baked Alaska. We're going to give you, we're really going to spoil you over there. I tease you slightly. We're just going to offer you some warm hospitality. Then you're welcome to invade the town of Scarborough if you want and go to the beach. Don't forget your bucket and spade if you're going to the beach. So again, just delighted to be part of the bigger picture, and thank you for making the journey from various parts of Middlesbrough in particular. I spent 31 great years up there in Middlesbrough, and it will always have a very special place in my heart, always. Good old Middlesbrough, and all those great days at the riverside as well. I was reminiscing about that fairly recently, the great days at the riverside, with Juninho and Ravanelli and Curtis Fleming and Gianluca Festa, all those great days, and our own Jonathan Greening as well, who was such a part of the riverside. Just to mention to parishioners, Margaret Bainbridge has died. Margaret was or is from New Farm Road, and she died on Sunday morning, so we await instructions. Some of you might know her daughter, Catherine. She works in Wilko's, always very helpful to me when I'm in Wilko's. So just to mention that. So we go now with the blessing of the Mass, and safe journey back to all who have to travel later on to various parts of Teesside. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you and protect you and keep your loved ones safe. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Go in the peace of Christ to continue to proclaim the gospel of the Lord.